Most Expo devs are missing out on powerful features already built into the Expo SDK. These tools can seriously improve your workflow, user experience, and app performance. Today, I'll show you 5 powerful tools you're probably not using, but should be. Plus, a bonus tip at the end that makes your app full stack. Let's get into it. Number 1. Caching builds. Expo SDK 53 introduced remote build cache. Instead of rebuilding your application every time, you can reuse builds across your team, if the fingerprint matches. That means faster continuous integration, fewer wasted minutes, and smoother collaboration. You can use EAS, GitHub, or even bring your own provider. It's just a couple lines in your app.json. I covered this in detail in a separate video on this channel, so check that out if you want a full walkthrough. For now, just know faster builds, less waiting, and huge productivity boost. Another underrated package I rarely see developers use is Expo Speech. It gives you access to the device built-in speech to text. Totally free and easy to use, it's great for accessibility, but you can also get creative. For example, I used it in my Foundation Models app to add a fun voice interaction layer. Just pass in a string and boom, it speaks. Let me show you a quick demo. So this is my Foundation Models app, and I thought it would be cool to have text-to-speech once we generate some text. So if we go to the basic generation, let's try tell me a joke, and I'll press generate, and I added this little button that says speak.
Sure, here's one for you. Why don't skeletons fight each other? They don't have the gods.
There you go. Of course, this might not be the best voice out there, but it's free and it's available on device. You can also switch between voices. Normally, new devices have many voices.
Expo modules are the best.
Personally, I think the default one is your best bet. Number 3, SQLite Async Storage. Expo SQLite is hands down one of my favorite Expo libraries. It's fast, reliable, and works across iOS, Android, and even web and macOS. You can integrate it with tools like Drizzle ORM, but here's the hidden gem. It includes a key value storage API that can fully replace React Native async storage. It's the same API, so switching is as easy as changing the import. Plus, it supports synchronous API too, which means you can skip a wait when you don't need it. Super convenient and super efficient. Number 4, Router UI. Another underrated feature is Expo Router UI. It's a submodule of Expo Router that gives you full control over your app's navigation layout. How many times have you struggled to style React navigation for web, desktop, or even TV? Expo Router UI fixes that. With headless tabs, you get the navigation logic without any styling. This is perfect when building for multiple platforms, phones, tablets, desktop, where screen sizes and UI expectations vary widely. You can fully customize the look and behavior of your navigation to match each platform exactly how you want. It's super handy, especially for large screens. I'll leave a link below to a Livestream with Mark and Keith, where they do a full deep dive on this. Let's move on to number 5, Background Task. Expo Background Task is a new module that lets you run custom logic even when your app isn't opened. Perfect for syncing data, preloading content, or scheduling updates. It works on both iOS and Android and can seriously improve your app's user experience. I recently made a full video diving into how to integrate it into your application, so I'll leave the link in the description if you want to check it out. And finally, we have a bonus, Expo Router API Routes. Expo Router API Routes let you write server-side code directly inside your React Native project. It's perfect for quick endpoints like Stripe integration, file uploads, or custom API calls. If all you need is just a couple of APIs, this is more than enough. And deploying? Just run EAS deploy and boom, your API is live with a free domain. If you want to go deeper, API routes also support streaming, advanced logic, and full stack capabilities. Plus, if you're building for web too, the EAS deploy command pushes your site and your API together. Or you can use the no-ssg flag if you just want the API. I use API routes constantly. They're simple, powerful, and incredibly useful. And that's it. 5 underrated Expo SDK features plus 1 bonus to boost your apps and workflow. If you learned something new, give it a like, drop your favorite feature in the comments, and subscribe for more content like this. See you in the next one.